I'm J.D. Arlen.
And I'm Mary Kaltwriter. Our top story, the saga continues in the case of the Barnett family, who recently pleaded not guilty to charges of child neglect.
I went to the Tippecanoe County Courthouse to get some answers from the now separated couple. Fast Track News spoke with the father, Michael Barnett's legal team, who says they feel overwhelmed.
To say they were shocked would be an understatement. They are still bewildered as to why they're even placed in this position.
Michael and Christine Barnett pleaded not guilty in their child neglect case in late September. The couple was accused of leaving an adopted Ukrainian girl in Lafayette and then moving to Canada without her. But the Barnetts claim she was no child at all. And Michael talked about her disturbing intentions on the Dr. Oz show.
The first time she tried to poison her. One day Natalia was being smiley and happy and I want to be a part of the family, and she decides that she's going to help do the dishes. Christine's got her coffee mug sitting on the table. She's happy that she's being a part of the family. Christine turns her back to go to another room and get something. By the time she returns, Natalia's already poured a whole bunch of Pine Sol into the coffee. When confronted about it, it was a plain and simple matter-of-fact answer, a very thought-out adult answer. I'm trying to kill you.
Christine Barnett has since requested a return home to Florida, something she wouldn't be able to do until the trial. Michael Barnett requested his address be redacted from public record, citing a safety concern. The Barnetts believe they're the victims in this case.
I think it is clear from the discovery that we, an investigation we have conducted, it is clear in our mind that they are in fact the victims of a fraud or ruse perpetrated upon them back when they were first requested to adopt this individual that was alleged to have been a child when in fact she was not.
The trial of Michael and Christine Barnett is set to take place in the Tippecanoe County Courthouse in mid-January, and that's just 3 months away.
Fast Track News will continue its coverage of this case as the story develops.